There's a story of a boy named Jacob who was locked inside and stuck in quarantine. The three others who were stuck there with him, Dad, Eric, and the Queen. And then one day Mom told him to be creative. In an hour it's almost ready. Two co-hosts, a blue screen, and Mom's iPad. And that's how we made Good Morning Brochettis. Good morning, Brochettis. And now here comes Good Morning Brochettis.
Good morning, Brochettis. Analysis: Trump's virus drug whim costs millions, even as the mania wanes. From Bloomberg. President Donald Trump has stopped talking about the decades-old anti-malarial drug he once touted as a game-changer for COVID-19, but it won't be as simple for the rest of the healthcare system just to move on. When Trump first began touting the drug in mid-March, a frenzy ensued in as hospitals, patients, and doctors raced to secure supplies. Many believed even if the drug didn't turn out to be an effective coronavirus treatment, it might be able to ward off infection. Astronomers just found this black hole near planet Earth, okay? In the night sky far south of the equator, there's a curious collection of faint constellations embedded in the tapestry of the stars. They do not bear the names of myths and legends because the ancient Greeks couldn't see them from the northern hemisphere. These constellations were charted later in the mid-18th century by a French astronomer who sailed south, and he named them in honor of some rather mundane objects of his own time: a telescope, a microscope, a pendulum clock, an easel, various other tools and chisels.
Cool!
Yeah. It looked like somebody's attic, an American astronomer later remarked. And just like a cluttered attic, this corner of the sky, two days in a row.
Yikes.
Yeah, and just like a, don't judge me.
And actually, I think you did not sneeze yesterday. I think you sneezed 2 days ago.
Oh, well, good. Then it's only one day in a row.
Ooh.
Yeah. And just like a cluttered attic, this corner of the sky has been hiding something truly remarkable. Now done with that news, we will now have story time with me.
I think it says,
hooray.
I think it says me.
Story time with me. Coming up.
With more enthusiasm.
Me. That's a little bit more enthusiasm.
No, a lot more.
No, I don't think I can.
With me.
All right, that's good enough for me. All right, and that's coming up next right here on Good Morning Brochettis.
What are we going to do for the intro?
I don't know.
Huh. Well, I think we should do something like, I don't know, what should we do?
I think we should have you read the book.
No. You just want to get out of it.
No, I think we can make an intro story time with Mrs. Bear, but
no.
Whatever. Alright. No. Why are you doing that? Yesterday was Star Wars, or...
No, it wasn't. Yesterday was Cinco de Mayo.
Yeah, 2 days was Star Wars Day.
Nice.
2 days ago was Star Wars Day. I'm fumbling all over my words.
Speaking of that, I think we still have the hat that Jacob wore on the interview segment area.
We do. It's right there.
Should I show them?
Why not? And then after you're done showing them the hat, we will cut to story time right here on Good Morning Brochettis.
Okay, let's go look at the hat.
All right.
Whoa!
There it is, the hat.
Bum, 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 bum. And cut!
You're in for a special surprise here on Good Morning Brochetti. Sierra's excited, everybody's excited. It's story time, and today we will be reading A Fly Went By by Mike McClintock and illustrated by Fritz Siebel. Now, joining me today and crawling along the ground is the writer-director of the show, Jacob. He's going to be in the audience listening intently and enjoying the story. Say hi, Jacob. Say hi, Jacob.
Why are you looking at me like that?
Because I'm asking you to say hi.
Hi.
There we go. All right. A fly went by for Kim and Leslie. I sat by the lake. I looked at the sky. As I looked, a fly went by.
Oh.
A fly went by. He said, "Oh dear." I saw him shake. He shook with fear. And when I saw that fly go past, I asked him why he went so fast. I asked him why he shook with fear. I asked him why he said, "Oh dear." He said, "I must get out of here." The fly said, "Look, and you will see that frog is after me." The fly went past. The frog came fast. I asked the frog, I asked him why. Why do you want to get that fly? The frog said, "Me? I want no fly, but I must hop, and this is why. That cat," he said, "just look and see. That cat," he said, "is after me." Then he was gone. With one big hop, the can ran up, and I said, "Stop! Now stop, stop, stop," I told the cat. "Do not pick on the frog like that." The cat said, "Look, I want no frog. I have to get away from dog!" So the fly ran away in fear of the frog, who ran for the cat, who ran from the cat, who ran from the dog. One ran from the other ran too, from one who came after. Now what could I do? Away past the lake went the fly and the frog. Away past the lake ran the cat and the dog. They went past a shed and they went up a hill. I ran and I said, "I will stop them, I will. The fly does not know that the frog is not mad. The frog does not know that the cat is not bad. The cat runs in fear of the dog, I can tell. If I can stop him, then all will be well." I ran a lot. I ran so fast. I came up to the dog at last. "Now stop," I said. "You are the one who did all this. Why do you run? Why do you want to bite that cat? Oh, you are bad to be like that." The dog said, "No, that is not so. I want no cat. The cat can go. I do not want to bite the cat. I want to get away from that. That pig. That pig," he said. "Look back and see. She likes to bite and she wants me." So the fly ran away in fear of the frog, who ran from the cat, who ran from the dog. The dog ran away in fear of the pig. My, she was mad, and was she big. I said to the pig, "So you are the one in back of all this. Now why do you run? Now why should a pig bite a dog?" I said. "And why are you mad, and are you out of your head?" The pig said, "I am not out of my head. See what is after me. Look," she said. "That cow will hit me," said the pig. "Those things up on her head are big." So the pig ran past. She ran past, fast. Then the cow ran up and the little cow too. I said, "Now what you got into? Do not pick on the pig, you two." The cow said, "Pig? The pig can go. That is not why we run, oh no. But someone bad has made us run. He wants to kill my little one." I asked the cow, "Who wants to kill your little one?" "Why, no one will." The cow said, "Look, up on the hill, the fox is there. He comes to kill." The cow and little cow run past, all full of fear as they ran past, fast. So the fly ran away in fear of the frog, who ran from the cat, who ran from the dog. The dog ran away from the pig, and now the pig ran away in fear of the cow. They came to the woods, and there was a tent, but they did not stop. In and out all they went. And last came the fox, so he was the one who made them all fear, and he made them all run. Yes, he was the one who was bad. I could tell. If I could stop him, then all would be well. I told the fox, "Oh, shame on you. Oh, shame, shame, shame. For what you do, you want to kill the little cow. You stop, or I will whip you now." The fox said, "Now what did I do? Why do you say, 'Oh, shame on you'? I tell you, I would never kill that little cow. I never will." The fox said, "This is why I ran. Back in the woods, I saw a man. I saw a man. He had a gun. He wants to get me. Now let me run." So the fly ran away in fear of the frog, who ran from the cat, who ran from the dog. The dog and the pig and the cows, they all ran. And then came the fox, who ran from the man. They came to a house and went down the hall. And when they went out, there was a big wall. But that did not stop them all. Oh, no, not at all. They ran and they ran. They came to a town. They went up one way and they went down. And went up one way and then down another. They ran and they ran, one after another. They came back to a bank, but they did not stop. They went in the bank with a jump and a hop. With a jump and a hop, they ran in, and then they went out the back way and ran on again. I ran as fast as I could. I told the man, "You're the one in back of this. You're the one who wants the fox. Put down your gun." "Fox, fox," the man said. "No, I saw no fox, but I must go. For you see, yes, you should see the thing that is now after me." "I did not see it," said the man. "I took my gun and then I ran, for I could hear it bump and thump. It was so bad it made me jump. It was so bad it made me fear. It was so big, it was so near. It must be 10 feet tall," he said, "and big and fat and bad and red. Why, it can bite and kick and kill, and it would do it, yes it will. I hear it now, come on, I say, for I must run and get away." Bump, thump. The man ran past, fast, fast, fast. "What did I hear? A bump and a thump. It was so bad it made me jump. I was about to run away, but then I saw the thing and say, it was not tall, it was not mad, it was not big, it was not bad. Was this the thing that made them run and made them fear? Was this the one? It was a little sheep, so tame. It came to me and it was lame. I saw what made the bump and the thump. I saw the thing that made me jump. The sheep said, 'Look at this tin can. I cannot get it off. I ran. I ran for help. I saw a man. I went to him, but then he ran. Why did he run away from me? I just want to help. I just want help, as you can see. I said, I will get help for you, and I can help the others too. For now, I know just what to do. Oh, man, I called. Come back here. This is a sheep, so have no fear. The sheep wants help, for it is lame. Come back here. Come back. Come here. And then he came. But still the others ran and ran. They did not know about the can. I had to call so they would hear. I had to tell them not to fear. I had to tell them all was well, so I had to give a great big yell. Stop! I said to them all, you must not run away. No one is after you. No one, I say. You all ran away, and now I know why. I sat by the lake, and there came a fly. The fly ran away in fear of the frog, who ran from the cat, who ran from the dog. The dog ran away in fear of the pig, who ran from the cow, so she was so big. The cow ran away from the fox, who ran as fast as he could in fear of the man. That man heard a thump, and he ran, and away he ran. It was just a sheep with an old tin can. I looked at them all, and then I could tell they all had no fear, and now all was well. So they all went away. They waved goodbye. So I sat by the lake and looked at the sky. The end. And I, yeah. Hope you enjoyed the first ever Good Morning Brachetti story time. That's all we have for the show today, Mrs. Bear. Mrs. Bear, hope you enjoyed. We'll see you next time on Good Morning Brachetti's.
Good morning.